and then Altair bravely defeated all of the Templar guards without ever getting hit. Hey, wait a minute. That's not how this book ended. I saw that shit. Fucking liar. Alright, anyway. Welcome back. We were gonna go, continue on with the prologue. No, not here. Did I really just...
Not here.
Oh, I'm good at this. Shit, where'd he go? I don't know. Man, it could be anywhere. Ooh. They left one alone. But that's not really important that I hide from those guys. I just wanted to see if that would work. I wouldn't mind beating them to death, but, you know. I guess if they're that stupid, then I guess I'll have a little bit of pity on them. So yes, last time we had a bit of bad news. Our father was arrested and thrown in jail on charges of a conspiracy. And our brother, our older brother and our younger brother were also arrested. Our sister and our mother were not arrested. They were taken to a safe place by one of the auditory family house wenches or something. And that evening, we went and delivered a secret letter to Uberto, oh boy, Uberto, the beef jerky salesman, telling him to use it as evidence to exonerate our beloved father and family. And now we're going to go witness the trial, I believe. Yes, I believe this is the trial. Maybe not, I don't know. That's an invisible thing. Okay. Either way, we're getting there. Last man standing. The acquittal of Petruccio Giovanni and Federico, our father and... I believe that's our brother, Federico? I believe. This does not look like an acquittal. That looks like... every male of my entire family is on the gallows.
Giovanni Auditore,
hey, Darth Vader.
You and your accomplices stand accused of the crime of treason. Have you any evidence to counter this charge?
Yes, the documents that were delivered to you last night.
I'm afraid I know nothing of these documents.
You fat bastard.
Need to get closer.
Shit.
In the absence of any compelling evidence to the contrary, I am bound to pronounce you guilty.
Bullshit.
You and your collaborators are hereby sentenced to death.
You are the traitor, Roberto, and one of them. You may take our lives this day.
Come on, Deus Ex Machina. Deus Ex Machina.
Father!
There. Grab the boy. He's one of them.
No Deus Ex Machina.
I'll kill you for what you've done.
Guards, arrest him.
So that's bad news.
Abatetem.
Don't.
Better run, boy.
Oh, it's like crackhead. Oh, man. So, one of the things that I do like about this game is that it doesn't really pull any punches. There was a great deal of brutality and Byzantine politics in this era and others. I know that that's just a small speck of it, really. It doesn't really even scratch the surface of the scope of the brutality that was prevalent in this era. But, regardless, to see it put so bluntly is, refreshing. If a little sad. Looks kind of sad. Poor Petruccio. Potato. All he wanted was some feathers. Stick up his butt so he could walk around like a chicken.
I've got a little request for you. I've identified several strange markings that I've discovered right across Renaissance Italy. Now, I don't know what they're doing there, but I want you to help me find out. Rebecca has marked their general location in the database with an eye icon, and she's made them glow as well. Keep an eye out.
I will do that. Areas of interest. Ah, here's the house wench.
Sir Ezio, thank God. I've been looking everywhere for you.
I couldn't stop them, Annetta. I tried, I swear. But there were so many guards.
Please, come with me. We need to get you off the streets.
What of my mother and sister?
They're safe. I'll bring you to them.
No,
oh, that's nice.
It's too dangerous for us to travel together. Tell me where to go and I'll meet you there.
My sister's house, just north of the Duomo.
I'm on my way.
I think I should probably take the tall way. Because of the whole, extremely notorious bit. And then there's those guys. Holy shit, look at that. That's my house. The, Auditore Plaza. Well, I was gonna show you all the guards standing on the roof, but then Ezio decided to facepalm his way off of the roof there, so instead we'll just alert all of the guards to our presence and run around like morons. Damn, I'm good. Let's take some peels. Rabbin peels. Medieval peels. Medieval peels here. I'm going the wrong way, but I do have to go around that big fuster cluck of guards. Speaking of which, there's some more of them down there. But that's okay. We've got pink hay. That's okay. We've got hay.
Isn't that illegal?
No. There. Sometimes you have to give Altair a little push. Sometimes he's just like, I feel like doing hippity hops. So that bit was a little depressing, and it's hard to make, you know, silly jokes and stuff, but, you know, they are digital people. When I first played it, it personally impacted me, kind of more than it ought to have, partly because of the, my brother and I have always been really close, you know, in a lot of ways, he was like a father to me, and, so losing two brothers like that and your father at the same time, that really sucks, and hey, look, there it is. But in the end, we're here to have fun.
So let's jump off things randomly.
Oh. Whoa! Altair, here to save the day when things start getting serious.
I think I'll dirt my way off the side of this building right here. Woohoo!
We should be almost there. I think this is the prison, possibly. Yes, this is the prison. And north of the Duomo. Duomo arigato, Mr. Assassino. Whee! One thing that I do like about this one, a lot more than the olden one, is, we're heading towards Guardsville here, is the accents and the dialect of the folk. Yeah, you can't see me because you have vision of 12 feet, you big dum-dum, so just give it up. Whoops. I'm over here now. You still can't see me. Oh, that's not going to end well. Ooh, that was close. There's a viewpoint up here on the way. Might as well pick it up. Because, hey, I'm taking my time here, remember? I'm enjoying my stay in Victorian intertime animus. I am enjoying my stay so far. I've actually been looking forward to this. Ever since I started playing Assassin's Creed 1, I've been looking forward to this. I had actually not played... This is the first time I've played the game since the first time I played this game. I fucking hate it when I say that.
This is the first time since the first time.
I don't want to fall down to street level, so I'm going to fall down to rooftop level and get my feet embedded in a roof. This building looks a little suspicious. Right. Okay. Why not? Hey, hookers. This isn't Grand Theft Auto. What are all these hookers doing here?
I think we have the wrong building.
No, this is it.
Thank God. Something's finally going my way.
It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance, Messer Ezio. Annetta speaks quite highly of you. I can see why.
I appreciate the kind words, Madonna.
Ti prego, call me Paola.
Thank you for offering your home to my family, Paola.
It was the least I could do. You must be tired. Perhaps you'd...
No, grazie. I can't stay.
Why? Where are you going?
To kill Uberto Alberti.
I understand your desire for vengeance, but the Gonfaloniere is a powerful man. You are not a killer, Ezio.
Spare me the lecture.
Not yet.
But I can make you one.
And why are you going to teach me how to kill?
I'm not. I'm going to teach you how to survive.
Come. This is where things get a little interesting. And this is how this relates specifically to Desmond. Because Ezio was not trained as an assassin, as I mentioned before. He became an assassin out of necessity and family lineage.
This is paramount in my profession. We must walk the streets freely, seen but unseen. You two must learn to blend like us and become one with the city's crowds. My girls will show you how.
Does it involve touching their boobies? Oh, right, yes, blending.
Come a little bit closer, Ezio.
Yes, ma'am. Can I just touch your... real... why are you leaving? But... boobies. I'm invisible. I'm learning. What? Oh, sorry. Hello. Uh-oh. Any of you packs of horrors want to come follow me? How about it? Follow me. Hey, lady, this pack of horrors doesn't want to follow me. How about I sit on a bench? So I'm supposed to... Well, there's a problem. There's a bunch of guards in the way, and... Oh, I know. I'm invisible. I'm invisible. Nowhere. Hello, I'll touch your boobies. That makes me invisible. Oh, that's it. If I touch boobies, I become invisible. Man, that's awesome. Touch your boobies. This would not work in a monastery. Uh-oh, I better go touch someone's boobies quick. Excuse me, ma'am. I'd like to become invisible. Thank you. Those are very nice. Your husband must be very happy. What the fuck do I do now? There's a bunch of... Oh. Apparently it's not boobs that do it. It's standing in a crowd. Dumb. Well, I'll still touch boobies. Thank you. Excuse me. Benches work too.
Another condottiere.
Do-do-do. Excuse me, ma'am. It didn't work. Crap. Hey, guys. Pretend you're a pair of tits and I am sandwiched in between them. What? I'm on your boobies? No, it didn't work. It worked. Delayed reaction boob sauce. Alrighty, that wasn't so bad. Are we there yet? 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 God damn it, Napa! Excuse me, I was just trying to turn invisible. Can I just, real quick, turn... Watch, if I... I'll show you. I turn invisible. See? Oh... Oh, Ezio, you cad. You cad. My bad.
Bene. Now that you've learned to blend, I'll show you how to use it for more than just moving around.
But will it blend?
Let's teach you how to steal.
Boobies? Can I steal from one of these hookers? Oh. Whoops.
Once you've stolen from someone, Ezio...
I think I wasn't supposed to do that yet. Dang it. Uh-oh. Okay, I'm supposed to steal from 5 different people. I picked you, and you, and you, and you, and you, and you. Cool. Excuse me, pardon me, coming through. I don't think I was supposed to steal from these hookers. Sorry about that, ladies. Let me touch your boobies to make up for it.
You can go now, girls.
Golf clap.
Oh, do we have to?
So innocent.
He's cute.
Now that you have learned how to approach the enemy, we need to find you a suitable weapon.
What would you have me use?
Ah, but you already have the answer.
Hey, my father's blade and bracer. How did you get them?
By using the same skills I've just taught you.
It's not exactly a working
condition. Touch boobies?
I assume you're familiar with Leonardo da Vinci.
See,
Albert?
What how does a painter factor into this?
He's far more than that. Bring him the pieces. You'll see.
So he's gonna make my Batmobile.
Before I go, one last question, if I may.
Of course.
Why have you given your aid so readily to me, a stranger?
I too know betrayal.
That sucks. Alright, so we're gonna go talk to Leonardo D. Albert and see if he can get our Batmobile working. And by that I mean Hidden Blade. Hiring groups. So we can hire those hookers now. Not to go have sex with us either. I don't know. Maybe we could hire them to do that too. Maybe we're gonna work out a 2-for-1 deal. Here are some thieves. What you can do with them, you can hire them to distract people. So if I hire these guys, like this, I give them some money, and they follow me around. Thieves are different than other groups, like the courtesans that we were just looking at. They can't follow you across rooftops because they're dumb hookers, and they will fall and die. But thieves can. So it's really nice for when something is being heavily guarded, or if you have to get through a narrow passage surrounded by guards, you can just go send your thieves to go get murdered hopelessly in your name, and they will. I need to be careful not to go through that little line there, because Ezio apparently never went there, the jerk. Sure would make my life easier if he had. There is a viewpoint here. And you know how I feel about viewpoints. The more, the viewier. There's a feather over there. You know what? Normally, I won't go out of my way for them, but just this once for little bro, we'll try. That's for you, potato. Sorry about your neck and stuff. Plus, it actually ended up working out for getting up here. Don't really know how the thieves are going to handle this. I think they're just going to wait. All the better. I don't think there's enough room on this thing for all of us. Although, it would be hilarious seeing them all fall off. Okay. No really easy way down except for these. Nice of you to wait for me. And I don't really want them to be around much longer, so I didn't run into any guards. I was hoping I would. I don't know. Whatever. Anyway, we found, Leo. Casa de Leo.
Oh, Ezio Auditore! I didn't expect to see you again. What with all that's happened.
Too soon.
Where are my manners? Welcome back. Now, how can I be of service?
I was hoping you could repair something of mine.
Batmobile.
Of course. Come, this way.
I need rocket launchers on it.
Let me clear a space.
Jet engine.
All right, let's see it.
Can you put a jet engine on that?
Fascinating. I don't know, Ezio. Despite its age, the construction is rather advanced. I've never seen anything quite like it. I'm afraid there's not much I can do without the original plans. Mi dispiace. Wait.
What are you doing?
The contents of this page are encrypted, but if my theory is correct, based on these sketches, it may very well...
It may very well what?
Please, sit.
Leonardo, eh?
Remarkable. If we transpose the letters and then select every third...
Nerd!
There. It's finished.
Get that off my cock.
Huh? What's finished?
Oh.
The blade. I managed to decode that parchment of yours. It showed me exactly what to do. Now all that's left is to remove your ring finger.
Really?
I'm sorry, but this is how it must be done. The blade is designed to ensure the commitment of whoever wields it.
Yeah.
Bene. Do it quickly.
I was only having fun, Ezio. Though the blade once required a sacrifice, it's been modified. You can keep your finger.
Cool. I can flip people off for... Although, I don't think it was that finger.